What is going on YouTube? I am back with a brand new video. If you're tuning in, my name's Pups, and this is Casual Hip Hop, a show where we get to talk about all things hip hop. So if you're new to this, guys, please do subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you can receive all my latest video uploads. But yeah, so like I said, this is a show where, this is a series that I started recently. This is episode 3, so if you want to check out episode 1 and 2, there's going to be a link in somewhere in the description or at the end of the video. I've got a few things to get through today, so we'll just get right into it. Firstly, your boy released a brand new song last week, so super exciting. The track was released on Friday. It's called Way Back, produced by John Rycard. And look, this is super exciting for me because I know that I haven't been like the most consistent in terms of like releasing content. So this is this is quite a relief and just super exciting to be putting out stuff, putting out more material and such. So yeah, if you guys want to support me, you want to support the single, guys, go on Spotify, Apple Music, or whatever digital platform that you use to consume your song, and it's all out on all platforms. So yeah, go stream the song, let me know what you think of it, send me your feedback, send me your DMs, I welcome all of it. So what's been happening in the world of hip-hop? Well, firstly, 50 Cent. 50 Cent seems to be have gotten himself into some legal trouble. There's a video that surfaced recently of him. It was during a show in LA where he hurled a microphone, and the microphone struck somebody right on the forehead. Yeah, 50, come on son, inevitably we know that's a lawsuit coming his way. The young lady, let me pull up the story. So if you watch the video, if you pay attention to the video that's out there, you can clearly see that he was performing a song with YG, and it appears that his microphone wasn't working, and the backstage crew and the production crew handed him several microphones, and all which weren't working. And you can clearly see in the video, he's visibly getting more and more frustrated, when he realized that the mics that he was being handed weren't working. And I guess, yeah, I think he finally had it. And you can clearly see, out of frustration, he just hurled the fucking microphone into the side, like the stage area on the side, like the side stage area. And reportedly, so this is where the young lady was standing, and the microphone, she was struck on the forehead, and it was enough to cause a massive a laceration on her forehead, resulting in her needing to be hospitalized. If you see the photos as well, I'm telling you, it doesn't look good. There's an article there written by some lady, Natalie, it doesn't really matter, just some reporter. It says that 50 Cent is denying purposely injuring a fan after a video of him throwing a microphone into the crowd at his Los Angeles concert went viral. Fucking, pretty hard to deny it. If you watch the video, it's pretty evident he's denying intentionally, hurling the microphone into the direction of the young lady. I think there might be an element where he didn't think, obviously he didn't think, in just hurling the microphone. He wasn't, I don't believe he was aiming it at the young lady in particular. She just so happens to be in the direction of where the microphone landed. And if we don't know anything about 50, we know he's the worst when it comes to aim. 50 can't throw for shit. 50 can't throw. If you guys can recall that legendary baseball pitch from a few years ago. yeah, it was really embarrassing. So his aim isn't really the best. And you can clearly see that, you know, in the video of him hurling that microphone, it's like, mate, you need to work on your aim. But nonetheless, yeah, he's now a subject of investigation for this incident, because essentially it is it's criminal battery. It's battery. Yep. 50, you're gonna have to pay up, mate. You're gonna have to pay up. And I heard that one of the show, I think the shows that he had in New York City, which went on for the two shows that he had, he reportedly made over $2 million. I mean, safe to say we can kind of suspect where that money's going. Yep. Should have been wise. And look, I think, look, even though, look, I'm quite open in terms of, you know, declaring that 50 is my favorite rapper, but like, this kind of behavior is just inexcusable. It's just very childish and very reckless, and thank God that the young lady is actually okay. But yeah, 50 needs to be held accountable for this. He needs to be held accountable. You need to learn how to manage your anger, manage your frustrations. You can't be going around hurling fucking microphones into the crowd just because you're frustrated, mate. Doesn't work that way. Good luck with that, mate. All right, moving on. Eminem. Eminem has grabbed quite a few headlines this week. Essentially, for sending a cease and desist letter to a presidential candidate by the name of Vivek Ramaswamy. Vivek was reportedly using Eminem's song "Lose Yourself" on his campaign. And you know, there's videos, you can check it out yourself as well. There's videos where you can see Vivek performing the song.
He opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's joking how everybody's joking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow, snap back to reality. Oh, there goes.
Yeah, essentially it's the theme song to his whole campaign. And Vivek, Vivek criticized Eminem for this because he explained that, you know, he resonated with the idea of being the underdog, which I guess Eminem is known for. And he felt like, I guess in his view, like the song was very representative of everything that he stands for, his campaign, you know, being the underdog and being the renegade. Was blown away that that the rapper would go to that length. I personally don't understand like why this is even a story, like why this is going viral. Because the essence of it, for me, at least in my view, Eminem's done nothing wrong, right? Artists reserve the right to protect their brand, and if they feel anything is being done, you know, which I guess might
compromise this
or has the potential to do that, they're well within their rights to take whatever necessary actions to prevent that from happening. And in this case, like if you see the videos of Vivek performing the song, look, it's so fucking corny. It's so fucking corny. I'm gonna play it one more time. It's so fucking corny. It's so fucking corny. No. fuck, bro. It's so corny. It's so fucking corny. It's so cringe, bro. Right? It's so cringe. Well, look, if I was Eminem, look, I will have done the same thing. The video, it's so corny, and as an artist who's worked so hard to build his brand, the last thing that you'd want is a politician like Vivek or others, to be parading around, I guess, yeah, bumping your song as a theme song to their fucking corny ass campaign. That's the last thing that you want. Because whether Vivek wants to admit it or not, like, this is inadvertently, like, you know, damaging Eminem's brand. Unfortunately, I'm sorry. Yeah, so in this instance, I feel like, yeah, Eminem reserves all the right to be able to, like, you know, send that letter, demand his song to stop being utilized for this fucking corny ass shit. Fucking kid, I'm gonna watch the video one more time. It's so fucking corny, but it's so hilarious. Ah, it's so fucking corny, man. No. Come on, son. This is so fucking corny. I'm sorry. I can't get down with that. That is corny as fuck. Excuse the bad language, but it's necessary. Fucking necessary, mate. Look, we're gonna move on. I'll fucking move on. There's a video of Warren G. Warren G, you know, legendary Warren G, was a guest on an episode of Drink Champs, you know, with Nori and his crew. Yeah, essentially, like, they played a game where, like, they ask you to choose one or the other. Warren was asked between Eminem and the game.
The game or Eminem?
Eminem.
Really?
Eminem is dope. I mean, I ain't saying game ain't dope, but Eminem is the motherfucker wrote Things Just Ain't the Same for Gangsters. He wrote that. That's one of my favorite fucking songs.
For Dre.
Right. How the fuck can you write this for this nigga and the shit sound like it's straight?
It's him, yeah.
Because M is he's a student of the game.
Yeah, so it's like Game was student of the game too. It's just Eminem.
Yeah, you're right, he is.
I promise you, that motherfucker wrote that shit like he was inside of Dre body in his head.
And then and obviously, like, you know, Warren sided with Eminem. And to me, I guess the reason why I'm bringing this up is because the co-host, I forgot his name, like DJ Effin. So DJ Effin had this look on his face, like, really, nigga? Like, really, nigga? You gonna side with Eminem? That's the look that he had in his face. And to me, like, that was just like, I'm like, why? That's just one of the most disrespectful things you can do. You gave the guy two options. He chose one. And then yet, like, you're surprised by his response. Like, Eminem is one of the greatest fucking rappers to ever touch a microphone. We know that. It's fucking established. Right, and I just felt like responses, like, you know, like DJ Effin's responses, or, you know, responses similar to that. I feel it's just kind of perpetuating this whole notion that I feel like it's part of, like, this rhetoric that's been going around for, I think, the past, you know, 5 or 6, 7 years, of people going out of their way to try to discredit Eminem for all that he's done for hip hop and try to diminish everything that he's done. And I felt like that was just super disrespectful, because Eminem has done so much for the game. And just to backtrack a little bit, if you haven't been keeping up with what's been going on, there's a few notable, I guess, figures in hip hop. There's so many of them, but we've got Lord Jamar. Yeah, Lord Jamar, who's, you know, a rapper. He's from the rap crew Brand Nubian. He's been going on, you know, every podcast that you can imagine, especially Vlad TV, and going out of his way to, I guess, discredit Eminem. And his whole stance is that Eminem does not belong in the house of hip hop because he's white. And Lord Jamar feels like, yeah, Eminem is a guest in the house of hip hop and he would never ever belong in the house of hip hop, regardless of how much he's contributed, regardless of how much he essentially done to elevate the whole genre. And I just feel like, you know, like people like Lord Jamar, I feel like it's beyond, it's kind of like, you know, teetering on the side of they hate Eminem because he's white, and they're not willing to acknowledge his actual skill as a lyricist, his contributions to the game, his impact on the game. You know, how many brothers, how many artists he's brought up, 50 Cent, D12, and all the countless others. Just, I feel like, yeah, they go out of their way to diminish like that. All those contributions don't really matter, because at the end of the day, Eminem is white and so will never belong in the house of hip hop. And I feel that's just very, very unfair, because I just feel like we're past that. The man has literally opened the door for so many rappers to come through, for white rappers to be accepted. And I just feel like, yeah, it's at a point where, like, I think they need to start commending Eminem for all the work that he's done, and giving props where it's due, because I don't think Eminem needs to prove to anyone that he belongs in the house of hip-hop. In fact, he's even, you know, expressed that in a single that he released with his new artist, Easy Mills, where he makes reference to that he helped build this house of hip-hop. It's now a mansion as a result of it. You know, which is true. You can't, Eminem elevated hip hop to and introduced hip hop to a whole new audience that will never otherwise have been exposed to hip hop as a genre. So you've got to give credit where credit is due. And I feel like the likes of people like, you know, Lord Jamar, Joe Budden to an extent as well. And, you know, we know with Joe Budden, there's a bit of history there as well. Joe Budden was signed to Eminem. And I guess, yeah, some shit happened there, you know, and then all of a sudden he flipped. But the likes of him, Joe Budden, even Game made some very corny ass comments. Game went on this whole kind of, you know, tirade a while ago. Maybe like about a year ago or so, where essentially he claimed he was a better rapper than Eminem, and he challenged Eminem to a battle, and he was essentially sick. My take was like he was just super jealous of all the praise and all the regard that's paid to Eminem. And instead of acknowledging the work and the contributions this man has made, Game jumped on the bandwagon and started dissing him and trying to discredit him as well. It's so ironic because Game's whole come up was because you can find a way to even attribute that to Eminem. You know, without Eminem, would there have been a 50? Without 50, 50 wouldn't have been able to essentially give Game all those hits that he had for his initial album, the documentary. So it's like, I'm going on a bit of a tangent here. But Game challenged Eminem to a battle because he felt he was a better rapper, as opposed to, you know, letting his body of work speak for itself. And I think it's just one of the corniest things you can do as a rapper, as someone that, you know, most people respected. I felt like, you know, he belittled himself and diminished his credibility, and because essentially, yeah, like he let his ego get the better of him.
So what did Game do exactly?
Game released a diss track to Eminem called The Black Slim Shady on his last album called Drillmatic. It was a super fucking long song, and he just goes, you know, he goes into it about, you know, like Eminem isn't the best rapper, and makes some really corny ass references, you know, regarding his skin color, about his inability to get waves because, you know, white people can't get waves. And that, you know, essentially like a, that was like a double entendre to the fact that, you know, Eminem had reportedly Eminem had never created a wave, which is just so fucking untrue. In fact, Game's whole fucking come up, he was riding off the wave that Eminem had created. He was fucking, like, he was riding the fucking wave that Eminem had created. You know, anyone can make that point, and I'm fucking making that point. You know, so it was just very sad to see that he, you know, the levels that you, you know, people will kind of stoop to just to sell records. But yeah, like, he released that diss track, said some very disrespectful things in there, and yeah, tried to essentially claim that, yeah, Eminem isn't the rapper that is regarded. And he does this by trying to mimic Eminem's flow, which to me is just like flattery, right? Like, isn't flattery like the ultimate, like, the compliment? At least that's my understanding of it. Yeah, so he thinks that because I'm able to mimic Eminem's flow and delivery, somehow this shows and demonstrates that I am an equal rapper, if not better than him. Like, what the fuck? This doesn't make any fucking sense, right? Because if he truly was, if he really felt like he was the better MC, mate, what you do is you establish something, you do something original, and let the copycats mimic that. And I'm sorry, but I can't think of anything that Game has done to the point where people, like, want to be him, where other rappers want to be him, where other rappers want to copy his flow, you know? So, mimicking Eminem's flow somehow makes you think that you're on the same kind of, like, playing field as Eminem. I'm sorry, buddy. No. So Game released that diss track. The track didn't go anywhere, as suspected, as predicted, right? Like, nothing came from it. You know, all we have now is a once respected rapper, you know, trying to maintain relevance by, instead of, you know, doing his own thing and putting out original pieces of work, he decides to go at one of the best rappers and tries to discredit him, not for his artistic skill or his lack of, but his skin color. And I feel like it's just further perpetuating this whole narrative that, yeah, Eminem isn't that great, and the only reason he's regarded that great as great was because of his skin color. And, you know, just to go back a little bit even further, like, if you recall, back in the day, Eminem had a song, I forget what album he was on, called White America. Let me find it. White America, I could be one of your kids. White America. Yeah, White America, that's the song. So White America, Eminem raps, he talks about essentially when he was coming up in the game, his skin color was a barrier for him, and nobody wanted to listen to him because he was white, right? And then he made it, and, you know, because of his skin color, you know, like, he was exposed to a whole bunch, like, a whole new audience that never otherwise, like, people don't even listen to rap, but yeah, he was exposed to a whole new audience and gained a lot of success through that. And then somehow he was critiqued and really, yeah, heavily criticized, because essentially they're trying to say that his skin color was now working to his advantage because he's only gaining success because he's white, when in actuality that was the initial barrier that hindered him from getting any access into the game when he was trying to come up in the early stages. So yeah, guys, go listen to that song. Honestly, it's just it's a fucking banger, and just the lyrics in there, the fucking delivery, just the message in the song, like, it's, yeah, blows me away. One of my ultimate, like, favorite songs from M. But yeah, Eminem, essentially, that's the kind of the early instances where he started addressing this kind of issue, because I suspected that he was experiencing this very early on. But nonetheless, look, yeah, so this whole rhetoric about Eminem being a guest in the House of Hip Hop. So yeah, Lord Jamar was running with that narrative. Joe Budden even started running with that narrative for a while, which is just so unexpected, because it's like, mate, you were signed to Eminem. He gave you a chance. And I couldn't even name a Joe Budden song for the life of me, apart from that one fucking song that was featured on that, what's that movie? It's like a breakdancing film. Yeah, that Pump It Up, pump it up, yeah, pump. Yeah, that's the only hit. That's the only song that I know of Joe Budden. And aside from that, all the other stuff that, you know, he's done with Slaughterhouse, because of Eminem. You know what I mean? So, this guy, yeah, he just needs to fucking
shut his trap hole.
Needs to put some respect on M's fucking name. And then on top of that, right, in the last, I think maybe 2 months or so, we've got the likes of fucking Melly Mel, right? So Melly Mel, an OG rapper from New York City. Yeah, like Melly Mel goes on this podcast. I swear to God, people need to stop fucking going on podcasts and just saying fucking outlandish shit. Especially, you know, shit that they regret, because, yeah, that seems to be what's happening. Yeah, nonetheless, Melly Mel goes on the show and he talks about, I think Eminem's name came up, and he was just very disrespectful, and he